The great opportunity was that when you have one of these other emergency locations and the price is quite substantial. So as those roads are used to be the bridges, the roads are connected, then there's really a big potential for some of these guys to catch up to those price that they're being paid. Okay, so the graphic is interesting, it is the impression form that is wired to tracking. It can also be ensured and put over to the right corner to take off any confusion. All these things are possible if you're interpreting the data. So let's have a little bit more of an in-depth look into the data. So here's the guy waiting for you behind that big break. We might say a little bit of what he does to them. They're A grade, B grade, and C grade. Right? And he does to them there. So let's have a look at the metrics around these things before what would happen. Total sales around 6,000, you know, the top mark is only 300 minutes. And then we grow it. Not so much to buy coming on. What we might like to highlight a couple of things. First of all, the rate is around 67% of the whole market. That is a market driver, that's a significant market share. And I'll talk a little bit in a minute about that. You can see where that's mostly located. And the obviously the cigarette having been away from the city, Connecticut, the larger areas, and a lot of the people who are land value to the North of the Bible of Christ. So this is some of the ways that I think it's located. And of course, that's going to be there. Right concentration in the southern area of the system, our area. And then finally, the A-grade, which is good enough, which is about 5%. And here we see those metro stocks again. So obviously, grade A is closer to the high value, high sales rate. That's a little bit of a snapshot of our first quarter performance. I think the prices went through lower or better. Let's have a look at our production supply on where we're at. So again, it's really, really cool to pay for the computer to see where the competitors are, what's happening, and that's pretty impressive. What's happening in the future, you can see, I mentioned before, that the historical supply has been in places grade 3, and for the region, most anything in India, we're moving through grade 3, into the top. Here, grade 3 is going driving into the market, having a quick look at grade 3, so we're heading to grade 3. And here, grade 3 is trying to put that in grade 3. So the near term, the next short term, the limited amount of grade A, still the grade B, but the market is driven almost entirely by grade B product. Let's now have a look at our residential echo. And this is pretty important because we're concerned about what the nature of the occupier is. Is it speculators? Is it investors? Is it organic or real demand? Obviously, we want the real demand. We get those other two. Purchase of motors developed, we look at it for help. We really want to focus on that. Why? Because that's a sustainable outcome. If we're occupied in there paying real money, they're only paying for it. There's no debt overhang, it's just real demand. So all these problems and ideas go away when you start talking about real demand. Hangover's coming up, as you can see, it's all great to see. Again, we might just have a quick look at the heat map, see where it is. First of all, well, I'm going to get to talk about the population. What's very good about the population is that we can take those history and census. We can see the school of 2019 coming up as we move just a little bit of time. We'd like to put it out on our future to find the numbers that can overlay the population so that we know where we're going to be, where the demand is. Okay. So now we might cross back to Ricky, seeing where he has progressed to.
Okay, so
So we went through handouts and recounts, and I've drawn where we are today. Thank you. making him slow, he's getting exhausted and stuff. This one is now under the administration. The industrial asset class in Vietnam has a lot of issues in the country. You see that the general along the other highway connecting it on the north. That is an enormous change. But also, all of the JIT facilities, all of the e-commerce, all the changing nature of the business and effective use of space is very, very much pressuring this investment class. So very interesting to have this choice. We have an intense amount of capital. It is a very, very fertile and active asset class, a lot of capital in the flowing from overseas. There is an interesting thing that Vietnam has in relation to Vietnam get to evolve as China, Thailand, Malaysia, where there are three or four major industrial owners with full tenancy in national pipelines. They then build around the economy. Vietnam is yet to have that pipeline that's coming in. So I think we're going to be a couple of years to some of these major players, obviously, or the industry, as I do, ending up like there are there.
World Economic Forum, 30 across all of these pillars.
Vietnam had the greatest increase in the digital world. Up to Malaysia, where they often lose the joint about 1 to 3, and then to 1 to 10. And the reason for this is that it is 12 pillars, hundreds of variables, that all come into this summary. And why Vietnam is working so well, what we want to look for is distance between these variables. That means previously is very complicated. And we can see that Vietnam improves very, very well. I think it's shocking. So you see that we also have more human rights in an Asian environment. That's the wrong place for a very, very good improvement there. And the other one is the market size. Previously, increased in market size. So let's go to the next one. So Vietnam is doing very, very well in relation to the very exciting. It's really because the 2019 census is coming up. That's a 10-year census. We're now at the census period. And so all the demographers are really thrilled and excited and doing demographic sort of stuff and accounting numbers. Why? Because that allows us to understand how the movement of population and what happens to the population. And the preliminary census data is out already. It's really cool and great. It's showing things like treating household size. We can therefore predict what's happening to households and society. These trends are not going to be creating a lot more households. That's really cool. You and probably don't need to look for apartments, more townhouses. The portion of households dropped only up to 4 people. So we've gone away from an old 13, 14, 18 concept. We're now just 2 or 4 people in terms of more of this stuff. This is really, really interesting. What's happening now in the community. So we're going to get a look at it. If you don't want to look at it, we'll be trying to go and get our invitation in the community that way. So very, very cool to understand information of the operation. I mentioned it before, and in relation to the urban isolation. So you can see the bloom of the remaining country after the majority rule, but this is a shift from rural to urban. It works along the northern culture and the territory world as well. What's really important is to understand how we're moving towards the city, urban population. So generally these things are pretty much the flat line. You can see the flat line suggestion coming up here, showing something around 20% general order. Vietnam is kind of predominant urbanized country living in the city. So what's the theory? Anyway, you can see we are way, way behind our peers. And the reason is the idea that generally Vietnam is headed towards the higher urban areas. Finally, when you look at Vietnam, and it is a very slow urbanizing country, and there's a lot of reasons for it. And the question is, is it going to speed up? And are you going to back that urbanization through? Or is it likely to continue on as it has done? And the difference both ways is because there's only 2 major cities, some of them are coming in already. After that, it got down to a million in there, and it's been like 3 or 500. What's it going on? We're all going to be 200,000 population cities throughout Vietnam. And there's a million. That perhaps they're not going to move. Perhaps they will stay in those sort of combinations. And so it's interesting to see how that group is going to move through. However, the wonderful stars in the region at the moment. There's something else more interesting in the country out here. Our interest is coming up, the open market. The open is down, the index is down. There's a lot of money out there. And, you know, there's private equity. The hundreds of years old with private equity and alternative capital sources. We're going to look at what's going on in the market shop. And these guys are the 81% clearer of the massive amount of that's why we get into the private market. They occupy a massive amount of space. So you see, there's good room for IPO in the border. Certainly, regional demand. The other thing is the new existing journey is we have some of our neighbouring countries with very enabling legislation and enabling tax reform to get rich going to the same level. So that is also an indirect option of investment that we make in the situation. We should see the reform in that area. So then moving on to the land price framework. But before having to pay for land, this has become very, very critical. It's been very popular in the region, land price framework. But what we've seen is that HCMC has not changed the stipulated price for the land price framework too much at all. The other side of it is the K factor is a figure. So the K factor multiplies the stipulated price, and we get to look at those K factors. So the relativity of the land price will remain the same. The K factor, which is accelerated multiply, will change a lot. So you expect the land price to go up, and maybe it could go up, because it might be going higher. So I think this is the World Bank here, as well as back now, we have a wonderful report a couple of years ago. It's all about the change of transparency, while we need to in particular, when you get to the strong use of land and property, I think in the most common cases, the property tax is one that the better, more equitable taxes, take off from those who can afford it, and those who make money,
that will therefore mean that
look at this very, very quickly across some of the images. You can see the pricing generally, you know, the box is going up to the mental key price range, it's done very, very well. Reasonable numbers across there.
We're not calling that enough.
head on, however, and it keeps getting more and more involved in under a lot of pressure, in particular, eroding to increase the energy and surrounding the demand and actually increase the energy to the income crop. Northern Mountain talks about the landslide, I think the overriding thing, and everybody complains about pollution and dust, Vietnam is an emerging country, it is developing, and by the very nice energy efficiency, emerging countries are generally suffering and have a lot of coal-fired power in some minerals, coal manufacturing. And so, in the top agreement, Vietnam is in under construction and manufacturing is going very well, and that's the consequence of emerging countries. When we are fully developed, then we can be very proud and show all the energy and not be coal-fired. We also have a very strong focus on renewables, so we're seeing solar that has run, as the product for power in the grid very good now, and we expect to see solar having a strong run as well. We also see national planning in coming years for the other challenges in the grid.
And then of course,
Ricky, thank you very much. I think it's been very interesting, especially in the short form, discussing how students use glass and iron and music and doing that live for the original. Thank you, George. Thank you very much. Thank you,